deep vein thrombosis is a massively undertreated condition around the world. Each year in Europe, it affects probably 300,000 to 400,000 patients, and only a fraction of those are receiving any form of interventional therapy. We believe that if you give patients an open vein, in other words, take the thrombus out, and then treat any underlying stenosis, they do much better as a result.
The main challenges of treating DVT is basically aging the clots and dealing with chronic clots and trying to find out how actually old the clot is. And it's not simple, as it could be layers of age in the clot, so there could be underlying chronicity in these. The other challenge is, what is the actual ideal imaging and clinical follow-up of DVT patients, factoring in the acuity and the chronicity of disease?
Well, the biggest challenge with the ATTRACT trial are obviously patient selection. They included the wrong patients. They included femoral popliteal DVT, should have included only iliofemoral DVT. Furthermore, are all the primary, secondary outcome measurements and where they put cutoff lines. So either you have PTS or you don't have PTS, which in fact would be much more logical to have a continuous line.
I believe the main issues with the ATTRACT trial was enrollment. About 1 in 2,500 patients were actually enrolled, because it was a trade-off between highly definable population and at the same time, is it really a generalization comparison with everyday clinical practice.
Compared to when the ATTRACT trial was commenced, or conceived at least in the early 2000s, at that time we were using non-dedicated venous stents. We didn't have access to good quality MRV or preoperative imaging. There was no mention of intravascular ultrasound. We didn't know how to balloon aggressively. We didn't know how to size the vessels. And we weren't sure about our anticoagulation regimens and follow-up protocols. So really, it's been so dramatically different. My practice now in 2019 is so different to what it was in 2005 that it's almost incomparable.
The ATTRACT trial didn't really change my daily practice. The only thing that I got from the ATTACT trial was to use better imaging. I used already good imaging, but now I'm absolutely sure that we use, for example, intravascular ultrasound in every single case.
We feel that the ATTRACT trial could have delivered a different result if it had used different parameters of measurement, for instance, not the Villalta scale. We think if you just used the venous disability scale, it would have led to a positive outcome. We also feel that if you use modern technology, modern imaging, modern stents, modern techniques, we would have got much better results. And I think that those are going to become manifest over the next few years in other trials, not necessarily ATTRACT.